Hello everyone, welcome to the daily reading. This is your daily message for tomorrow, February 10th, 2020. Thank you all for coming back, watching these daily readings, which go on for 7 days. Also, I am planning on bringing back the weekly readings, possibly also bi-weeklies. Thank you for those of you who have requested those to come back, because it lets me know that you miss them. And it'll be worthwhile for me to go ahead and put more effort into doing those. So definitely plan on seeing more of those coming up the next couple of weeks. For your reading today, we are using the Modern Witch Tarot deck and the Numinous Astro deck, which I just got. So you'll have to bear with me as I am still learning some of the cards there, but pretty straightforward, actually. Anything else? We do have a full moon in Leo today, which is the 9th, but at least on my calendar, so I'm not sure. Some people, it was on the 8th, depending on where you are in the world. The calendar in front of me says that we have the full moon today, so happy full moon to you. If you are a Leo also, it's an awesome day for Leos. Let's go ahead and see. Spirit, what are the messages and energies you'd like to share with the collective? Oh, this is a general reading for all signs, so I'll call out the signs as I see them. The reading may not resonate with everyone. I always say the more you watch these daily readings, the more likely you will resonate, as the messages are universal, mostly. There can be specific messages, of course. That's why I say I'll call out the signs as I see them. Let's see what's going on, though, for the collective for tomorrow. Monday, February 10th, 2020, for all signs. All signs. This particular deck does not like to be shuffled in reverse, so gotta keep that in mind. Messages and energy, spirit, for the collective for tomorrow. February 10th, 2020. What do we need to know? What are the most important energies and messages you'd like to share with my viewers? Have to say, I really do not like not reading with reversals. It feels weird to me, but I've learned that with this deck, the cards just don't like to be shuffled that way. So we do have the World, we have the Five of Cups, and we have the Three of Cups. I'm seeing Scorpio coming up here, Cancer, Pisces, and we also have the fixed signs Aquarius, Scorpio, Taurus, Leo coming up. And we have the Fool, sign of Aries, sign of Virgo, sign of Sag, of course, the Fool, the Traveler, the Free Spirit. We have two major arcana here, so I'm seeing major endings and major new beginnings. I don't know if you guys can see that. Let me just move these over. Yeah, I'm kind of OCD about the cards being not crooked most of the time. Yeah. I'm definitely seeing, yeah, like I said, endings and new beginnings here, the end of a major cycle, wrapping things up here. Could be a graduation ceremony. Obviously, could also be here. I've seen this, depending on the other cards, representing pregnancy or conception, you know, finding out that you're pregnant or finding out that you are indeed going to be having a child. For other people, most of the time it just indicates wrapping up a cycle, a major completion here, victory. Now, I have to say, I am really getting this for the fixed signs. I feel like today is a really big day for a concluding something. Mostly, I'm getting the feeling that this is a new chapter for a lot of people. New beginnings as well. So as one door closes, another door opens. I'm sure you've heard that expression. I feel like someone here is not that happy about this, though. Now, the World can also represent travel, ending a journey, right? Or ending and then beginning a new journey somewhere else. Yeah, I feel like there's someone here who's rather sad or disappointed The Five of Cups indicates regret, loss, disappointment. It feels like there's people celebrating behind someone's back here, or that people are happy about something finally being over. I feel there's at least one person here who is not happy about it, but they're not seeing. There's something here that they're not seeing. I could be reading for water signs, Scorpio, Cancer, Pisces. I feel like, for the most part, I'm getting the feeling that some people are celebrating while others are hearing pissing in their cups, or they're just sad and pissed off and can't find anything good to celebrate. But I feel like the majority of people here are happy. They're celebrating. They're with their friends. It's interesting because we do have the Three Cups spilled and then the Three Cups upright. So I feel like someone here feels like they've lost their friends. They may have at least one good relationship here, but they may feel like with this ending comes a loss of a group of friends that they used to hang out with. This could be someone that lives in, I'm getting New York City, I'm getting Bay Area. I'm also getting the feeling here that, friendships come and go. I'm not saying that people are disposable, but I'm feeling like, these weren't really your friends. Are these people, if they're celebrating, are they happy that you're losing something or that you've lost something? They really weren't your true friends to begin with. Okay, so because I'm getting kind of like, I'm getting a very like sort of angular situation here where if you knew that people were happy about this, you would probably feel even worse. But you could probably this person probably knows that people are happy or people are celebrating behind their back. They probably that's why they're sad, that's why they're upset. But underneath it all, we have the Fool, so inevitably there is this new beginning today. The Fool doesn't have any baggage. This person, they just have their cell phone, their earphones, just their dog. This can be someone who is ready to take a risk, ready to take that leap of faith, ready for a new adventure. This can be someone that's finally single, or ready to be single, ready to live the dream, Doesn't have a care in the world. They're finally free. Doesn't really give an F. I could be speaking to someone who is an Aries, a Virgo, any of the fixed signs, obviously. I really feel like the person here that's grieving could be a water sign, though. Scorpio, Cancer, Pisces. I'm getting that pretty strongly. Let's go ahead and pull. Ooh, I was gonna say, let's go ahead and pull a card from the Numinous deck. And we have Aries. So, yeah, I could be reading for someone who is an Aries or dealing with an Aries. Aries, the radical. Because we have the Fool here. And just some characteristics about Aries. They're active, they're self-starting, they're daring, they're fierce, they're assertive, fiery, exhilarating, innocent. On a mission, bossy, driving, sparky, courageous, selfish, macho, impulsive, argumentative, and competitive. And of course, we do have Venus that just moved into Aries, and we have Chiron in Aries. So, I may definitely be reading for an Aries here, and we have the opposition here, balance. So, as I was saying, I was getting a very angular kind of situation here. So oppositions, when you look at a birth chart, or if we're even talking about, people who are for or against you, you have to look at your opposite placement. So this could be, for example, someone that has, is dealing with their opposite sign. So South Node, North Node, that kind of thing. So, of course, they could be dealing, Aries would be dealing with Libra, or Aries could be dealing with, Venus and Aries could be dealing with their opposite as well. So, oppositions are talking about relating, mirroring, interaction, confronting, making conscious, manifesting, disciplining, conflicts with tests or conflicts with people, testing, objectifying things or calling out something. So definitely any of those types of situations could be coming out tomorrow. Someone may be relating to you, mirroring you, interacting with you, confronting you, making something conscious about the way that you do things, or something is made conscious to you. Someone is manifesting tomorrow. Someone is being disciplined. Someone is conflicting with you, testing you, objectifying you, or calling you out. And again, I'm getting Aries here, so that is going to be a major theme tomorrow. And I suspect over the next week or so, since that Venus Chiron in Aries is pretty strong. We also have that Mars in Sag and Moon in Leo, so a lot of fire coming out. But of course, the Fool, very independent, someone that doesn't really, have really a care in the world. They have no baggage, right? They're a free spirit. So, this is someone who could be acting in radical ways. The way that they act is conflicting with, like, maybe their group of friends, or maybe they've just decided to end something, and they couldn't be happier about it. And that may really anger, piss off, or make people sad. So, anyway, it's a good day to be in Aries. Let's just put it that way. It's a good time, I feel like, to embrace this energy. So, even if you do see it playing out in your life, just know you can at least be conscious of what that is for you. What that what how that's relating to what's going up in the sky, right? As above, so below. So anyway, guys, this is your daily message. Thank you for tuning in. If you'd like to book a private reading with me, information below in the description. Feel free to check out my website or scheduling page. Have a wonderful day. I'll see you back tomorrow.